wouldn't tell me the world. Yet, we are helpless refugees to them invasive nets. In the last video, we've completed the goldfish mesh and animation. In this one, we'll be making their materials. So the theme of this material is to make it realistic as a flock. We won't be focusing on the details of each goldfish like how scales should look. But instead, we'll be creating a system so each one of them will end up with unique patterns. They will be referencing a single material, but won't look like copy and paste. If you're really determined to make scale material, I'll provide a link for a tutorial in the description. As a preparation, let's UV unwrap them meshes. Starting with make body mesh. Create some space before curve to mesh. Then, drop capture attribute on top of both input connections. Connect a spline parameter factor to empty input socket. Then, connect the result to X and Y of combine XYZ. Add a store named attribute after curve to mesh. Then change the type to vector and domain to face corner. Name it UV, then store the result of combine. Select these nodes and Ctrl G to group them. Open up the side panel, then rename output to mesh. Top input to curve, bottom to profile curve. Reorganize a bit. Then tab to exit. Rename the group to curve to mesh UV. Tab out to the top layer and enter make dorsal fin null group. Replace a curve to mesh with curve to mesh UV we just made. Don't we just love how Blender can even recognize the acronym of handmade node groups? We'll do the same for pelvic and pectoral fin meshes as well. For the eyes, since we made the iris mesh separate from the rest, let's make sure we can change the material as well. Add a store named attribute after transform geometry on top, change the type to boolean, and call it BIris. Drop it on the bottom connection as well, and set the value to true. Now that we've prepped the attributes for shader to use, let's split the window and open up a shader editor. Click on new for new material, call it M body. Then delete the principal BSDF for now. On the geometry side, within make body mesh, add a set material at the end. Then, select M-Body. Back to shader. Let's first confirm that UV is unwrapped as expected. Add an attribute and enter UV. Connect it to surface and change the view type to material preview. Looks like unwrap is working. We'll start working on color and patterns. Goldfish patterns basically consist of three distinct colors. Add three RGB nodes, then set them to yellowish white, orangish red, greenish black. Goldfish patterns can be drawn up with one or a combination of these colors. Let's start by adding red to white base. Connect white and red to mix color A and B, then connect to output. Next, from UV vector, connect a noise texture. Then change scale to 10 and detail to 5. You can see a little pattern appearing, but not enough contrast. Add a map range after noise texture. Then set from min to 0.5 and from max to 0.51 for higher contrast. We'll flip the 2 min and 2 max so we can control the red amount. To control the amount of red, connect the value node to from min and add 0.01, then connect to from max. This way, you can adjust the red ratio while maintaining the contrast. Currently, fully white is about 0.25 and fully red is about 0.75. Let's add another map range and set the 2 min, 2 max to 0.25 and 0.75. So we can control its factor between 0 and 1. Alright, let's reorganize a bit and create some space. Select all these nodes and Shift D to duplicate to the right. Delete the white and red, then connect the result of first mix to A, black to B. When we output, black pattern will appear on top of the red. It's completely covering the red. So, instead, we'll make some space after the attribute, insert a vector mass add, and enter 0.5 in all directions. Black pattern is now shifted and no longer on top. Right now we are controlling the red and black ratios here. But I want to be able to do it externally. On the geometry node side, go back to the top layer. Make some space right before group output, then add a store named attribute. Name it redFac. Connect to group input. Then, name the argument redFactor. Clamp it to 0 and 1 by changing the min max values. Same with black. Add a store named attribute, rename to blackFac. Then, make an argument blackFactor. On the shader side, delete the value nodes connected to map range. Replace it with attribute. Then enter redFac and blackFac. Now we can control the red and black ratio externally. Let's now select these nodes and group them. Call it setColor. Add the principled BSDF backend. For parameters, fun fact, metallic luster of fish scale is not actually metal, but is a structural color made from multiple layers of crystallized guanine. So what does that mean? That means 0.95 metallic, since I have no idea how to recreate such color. Same with roughness, I'm going to guess about 0.6. To be honest, if it shines, it'll look like goldfish. So I won't be making scale material, but I'll be making a fin material to distinguish them from body. Add an attribute UV. Connect vector to wave texture and connect to output. Wave pattern is running vertically, so let's turn band direction to Y. Enter 10 for scale and 1 for distortion for a little imperfection. Then, add a color ramp and shift the right slider to the left. Change the right color to light gray, left to darkened white. Branch from set color and connect the mix lighten. Then, connect the color ramp output to B and increase factor to 1. Now the fin spines are colored separately from the rest of the fin. Duplicate the principled on the top and add it after lighten. There's no luster on the fin, so set the metallic to 0 and roughness to 0.4. Adding 0.6 to transmission will allow for some color to pass through from the background. Now, connect the two principled with mix shader. Duplicate the UV attribute and bring it to the right. Connect a separate XYZ from vector. Then, X to color ramp. Shift the left slider to the right and right slider a bit to the left. Connect the result to mix shader factor. This will cause the fin material to be applied to only the causal tail fin. Alright, let's reorganize. End body looks like this. Next, we'll work on individual fin materials. Let's duplicate the M body and call it MFin1. In geometry node side, go to make dorsal fin and add a set material right before group output. Select MFin1. In shader side, we don't need the scale luster portion, so select these nodes and delete. Then, directly output the principled BSDF. Let's take a closer look. The spinal direction is not correct. We want them running vertically. So change the wave texture direction from Y to X. Fin pattern scale also seem not to match the body. Let's directly output the set color for better view. Let's turn noise scale and set color into argument to control it from outside. Connect the noise texture scale from red to group input. Duplicate it and do the same for black. Exit out with tab and let's decrease the scale. The value of 4 seems to be a good size. Now that the pattern is set, let's plug the principle back in. The dorsal fin seems to be good to go. Next, we'll work on pelvic fin. On geometry node side, in make pelvic fin, add a set material just before group output. Let's see if MFin1 works. Again, the wave direction is wrong, so we'll need to separate material. Duplicate the MFin1 and rename it to MFin2. Select MFin2 for set material. On the shader side, change the wave direction to Y and decrease the scale to 2.5. Pattern scale should also be turned down, so let's use 2. We can confirm by directly outputting set color. For the pectoral fin, we can use the same MFin2. On geometry node side, in make pectoral fin, add a set material before group output. Select MFin2. If we reconnect the principle directly, this is how it looks. However, we seem to have an issue. As you can see, fins have the same patterns, pelvic and pectoral. Also, left and right side fin appears to be the same. For me, this is not acceptable. To set differing patterns, we'll need to change the referencing coordinate of noise texture. So after UV attribute, insert a vector mass add. Then, connect the object info random into bottom socket. Red pattern is now separated out, so do the same with black. All the patterns on fins are now different. There's no more changes to set color, so I'll show the whole picture. Reconnect the principled, and we are done with fin materials. Lastly, we'll work on the eyes. This is the easiest part. For now, let's just duplicate the mFin2 and rename it mEyes. We'll just leave the output and delete the rest. On geometry side, in make iMesh, add a set material before group output. Then select mEyes. On shader side, add a principled back in and connect to output. Add an attribute and enter bIris. Prepare a mix color. Then set A to yellowish dark gray. And B to black. Plug the result to base color. And set roughness to 0. I think this is good enough for an eye material. Alright, let's see it in action. Looks quite nice. And I think it will pass as a goldfish. As mentioned in the beginning, we don't want the materials to seem copy and pasted. We kind of accomplished that during this process. Let's duplicate the goldfish mesh and see how they look. As you can see, as we duplicate, the pattern becomes different. This is due to the object info randomness we added in the set color null group. Even with the same setting for red and black factor, patterns differ so uniqueness of each goldfish is preserved. When we also add differing red and black factor, we'll have more pattern variation as well. Alright, we'll go over what was made. In the geometry node side, in the top layer, we added these two store named attributes. For make body mesh, we modified curve to mesh node to UV unwrap. Here is the content of curve-to-mesh UV. We use this curve-to-mesh UV for dorsal, pelvic, and pectoral fin as well. For the iMesh, we added store named attribute to separate out the material for iris. On the material, this is mEyes. Next, mBody. Set color is the same for fins as well. Next, mFin1 for dorsal fin. Lastly, mFin2 for pelvic and pectoral fins. Alright, we're done with goldfish now. It might have felt long, but we did not just complete one goldfish. We just made a system to mass produce infinite amount of them. In the next episode, we'll use a flock controller to instance these goldfishes. See you in the next one.